We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on the Show. Tonight, an intriguing matchup between the Chicago Cubs and the Milwaukee Brewers. So stepping in, Javier Baez, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Two balls and a strike to Javi Baez. And this will miss as well, so he's in danger of losing the leadoff man here tonight. It's 3-1 now. And he lays off ball four, and the leadoff man is on to begin the ball game. The next Cub up, Jason Hayward. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. And he popped him up. Sogard into shallow center, but he won't get there. It falls in.
Batting third, the third baseman.
Into the box now, Chris Bryant. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. From the belt, kicks and deals. High and deep down the left field line. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Got to find a way to keep his hands back.
Fouled off. Baez over at second. Hayward at first with no outs. A full count, three balls and two strikes.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
And I don't think that's what he wanted to do, as the bases are loaded now with still nobody out. Now the 2-1. 2-2 the count. Tight spot. Bases loaded. Nobody out. Ground ball to second. This could be two. Sogard has it. There's one. But they will not have a shot at two. He's safe at first. And that will play to our opening marker of the ball game. So digging in now, Anthony Rizzo. And a great chance here for the Cubbies to add on in just the first inning. A ball and two strikes to Anthony Rizzo. Looking at his lifetime numbers, Rizzo comes into play with a slugging percentage over 490, just shy of 500. So he's looking to inch closer to that nice plateau right here. Got him swinging on the fastball there. Anthony Rizzo is the second out of the opening frame. And able to lay off the fastball away here. 2-1 now.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Lifted in the air out towards left center. Garcia has a read on it. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. Striding into the box, Lorenzo Cain. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Heading out towards shallow right. Therefore, it is Hayward now, one away. Here's Brock Holt now. Five base hits in the series for him through nine at-bats, so he's been very productive at the plate. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. Lester has worked his way through more than 2,500 innings in his career. And in that time, he's compiled a whip under 1.3. Translation, he's better than league average in that category. Hit high and deep to straightaway right field. Back goes Hayward, and it's gone. Plate now, Christian Yelich. 1-2 for Christian Yelich.
Hey, I love that pitch right there. Better execution after just giving up an extra base hit.
And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Baez is underneath this one, and there's the second out of the inning. So bases are cool. Empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up Abisaiu Garcia. Two out, nobody on. Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. Little chopper back to the mound. And the off-balance throw gets him as he takes away a hit and the side is retired. And that'll bring in the Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. Nine at-bats for him in the series so far, and he's collected a pair of hits. Low with the fastball that time. Two balls and two strikes. Fastball got him looking, as that had two-seam action on it, one gone. So one away here with the bases empty. And standing in now, the power-hitting second baseman, Jason Kipnis. Left side, but well foul. Good battle. Count remains full. A payoff pitch one more time. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Yanked high and deep down the line in right. And it's a foul ball.
Hey, have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
And he'll make the catch. Oh, check that. He didn't look it into his glove, and the ball drops in. And he's safe. Coming to the plate now, John Lester. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. But sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Pulled toward right center field. Coming in on it is Kane. And he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. Digging in for his second at bat, Javier Baez. He reached on a walk in his last time up and later came around to score. One and one. Here it is. Looking at his career totals, Baez is slugging north of 480, which puts him among some of the best power hitters in the game in that category. Cubs shortstop with a 3-1 count. Jason Hayward would be next. Gets him to swing and miss there. 3-2.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your A swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power letting it eat.
And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Digging in now for the Brewers, Jed Jerko, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Starts to go around here, but it doesn't matter. This is strike two anyway. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second. Now with the plate, Eric Sogard. And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. And it's fouled away. Nobody out, runner on first. Liner towards second, leaps high as he makes the catch. Well done. Stepping up to the plate, Manny Pena. He'll get to take his first cuts here. It's a breaking ball that's taken for a ball. Runner on first here with one gone and a 1-1 tie. Out in front here as this one scorched foul to the left. Working for the punch out and the offering. Grounder down the line at third. And that's a fair ball as this one gets by him at third. So now to the plate, Orlando Arcia. A ball and two strikes now. This one's flared off to the right side. And nobody can get there in time. Base hit. And a good throw is going to hold that runner at third. So they're loaded now with only one away.
Adrian.
In now, Adrian Hauser. Now a swing here on the fastball as this is squirted up the first baseline. And Rizzo won't get to this one. It's a fair ball. One run scores. He pulls into second safely as they take the lead with two runs scoring on the play.
The center fielder, number six, Lorenzo.
Standing in now, Lorenzo Cain. Rizzo is there. And he'll step on first himself for the out. Two men on, two out, and that'll bring up the versatile utility man, Brock Holt.
Yeah, that last at-bat, Danny, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile, but, hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Liner toward right center. That gets down, and the inning will continue. One run scores. The throw to the plate. And not in time as he just crosses the plate in time. At the plate, Christian Yelich. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. So a full count now.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Throw in time, and they stop the bleeding as the side is retired. Here's Jason Hayward now.
Lots of baseball left in this one as we're still early on, but you don't want to fall too far behind. They're already down by a bundle, and one of the things you want your leadoff guy to get on and set the table for the big boys to start driving in some runs.
And he fouls this one off. Now another 1-2. And a good curveball gets him swinging for rap number one. Here's Chris Bryant now. Seven hits, six RBIs in the series to this point, so we'll see if he's a factor again in this one. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Bryant looking at a 3-1 count.
They know the threat this guy possesses at the plate. I know it's 3-1 in this situation right here, but I can't imagine.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Definitely had the distance, but it winds up a foul ball. Now the 3-2 pitch. Down the first baseline. He'll try it again, 3-2. Now a slider here, but this will miss off the plate away, and it's ball four. So in now for Chicago, Wilson Contreras. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Hit down the third baseline. The 1-2.
Wanted to get the front door curveball on the inside corner there, but it backed up a little and stayed off the corner.
Swing and a little blooper to center. Coming in on it is Kane. He can't get to it. This one's down. And he is in there.
The first baseman, number 44, Anthony Rizzo.
Into the box now, Anthony Rizzo. And he got him to chase after a bad one there, 2-2. With two strikes now and a runner at first, do you go for the strikeout or are you still looking for the double play ball?
Pretty good spot to be in as a pitcher right now. You can go for the punch out or try and induce the...
And the throw to first is there. The inning is over. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Striding forward now, the Brewers cleanup hitter, Avisail Garcia. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Hap is right there, one down. So striding in, Jed Jerko. He scored after reaching on a walk in his first at bat. This is line to left. Schwarber is going to get there as he backs up to put it away. And there are two gone now. Here's Eric Sogard. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat. Ready on 3-1. Here it comes. Drilled to the right side. And this will get through into right. And he's aboard with a single. To the plate now, Manny Pena. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now. Fouled away. Two out with the man at first. The count is 2-2 to the Brewers catcher.
When a pitch is close to working through a quick inning, that's when you really need to grind out some at-bats. He's done a good job of that, and that's really big when you're hitting towards the bottom of the order.
The 2-2 one more time.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Making him work out there. The ninth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Hit hard up the middle. That's through for a base hit. He's now 2-for-2 in this one. And the throw will come in quickly from center. So despite the hit and run, they won't get the extra base here. At the plate now, Orlando Arcia. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. And a good take there will push it to 2-2 now on the Brewers shortstop. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Payoff pitch one more time. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Lester sets. Full count pitch on its way. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings. Bases are loaded here, two down. Hit down the line at first. Rizzo is there, and he'll take it to the bag himself, and a great job of pitching out of the bases loaded situation as the side is retired. All set for the start of the inning, so coming to the plate, Kyle Schwarber. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
The center fielder.
So one away here in the Chicago fourth. And that'll bring up the former first rounder and Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two. Fouled off. 5-1 our score as we play the fourth here. Fastball is outside and it's full now, 3-2. Waiting his turn on deck next is Jason Kipnis. Hap with a swing and he connects, sends this one to deep right field.
Gone!
Stepping in now, Jason Kipnis. Fastball, close, but he didn't get it. 2-1.
Hey.
2-2 now. Two runs, three hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. And that's the second out. Now to the plate, the pitcher, John Lester. 0-1 for him here in this one. 1-1 is laid off for ball two. Sent on the ground out to second. And the pitcher's got himself a base hit.
The bat, number 9.
In now, Javier Baez. Skied into straightaway right. Yelich is under it. And the inning is over. Next from Milwaukee, Lorenzo Cain. He started out the evening 0-2 so far. 2-1, here's Lester's offering. Hard hit at third, right to Bryant. And there's one away. Digging in, Brock Holt coming off the clutch two-run single his last time up. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Waiting next, there's Christian Yelich. He pulls this one into right. So he'll add one to his total as that falls in. He's got three hits in this one. At the plate, Christian Yelich. There's a swing and a high pop-up. Bryant over to his left. Two down. Digging in,
Avisail Garcia.
It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Brent Suter will come on out of the bullpen as he'll be appearing in his third game this season. New inning set to get underway. Stepping up now, Jason Hayward, 1-2. He singled and struck out in two trips. This is popped up. But this will land untouched. The 2-2. And it's fouled away. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Here's a fly ball, well hit. Yelich going back to the track. But he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. And he is into second base with a leadoff double.
Now back. The third baseman.
Into the box, Chris Bryant. Outside, 2-1.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
Bonnie gets him to wave at that one. It's 2-2.
That's not a pitch he misses very often. He knows he should have done something with that one.
And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
These last two guys are making him work quite a bit out there. Both have been long at bats, and all in all, he's had to make 13 throws just to them so far.
Line drive, base hit into the left center field gap. And that'll plate the runner from second and make it a bit more interesting at 5-3 now.
The catcher, number 40, Wilson Contreras.
So now to the plate, Wilson Contreras. For short, hit hard. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. There's Sogard for one. Relay throw, but it'll be too late as he's well safe at first. Anthony Rizzo stands in now. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. Ready with two balls and a strike. Popped him up. Holt in foul ground. And he makes the catch for the second out. Now with the play, Kyle Schwarber. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, Matty, big time K last time up, and it's been a tough series for him so far. You can tell he's just not seeing the ball off this team. Let's see if he can make an adjustment right here.
And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. Two and two.
You know, from a hitter's perspective, you get pounded in, and then he throws a nasty changeup away. Is the mindset to tell yourself that he's going to go in and out all day long, or is he going to double up? That's the cat and mouse we're seeing right now.
And the throw to first will indeed get him. It's a strikeout, score at 2-3, and the inning is over. Set now for the bottom of the fifth. Now at the plate, Jed Jerko. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the placement.
Bryant shading to his right, and that's the first out of the inning. So one gone in the Milwaukee fifth, and that'll bring in utility man extraordinaire Eric Sogard. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. There's ball four. Into the box, Manny Pena. It was a single for him in his last at bat.
Manny Pena.
Runner.
The 1-1 home to third. Bryant is up with it. Throw gets him, two down. So a runner in scoring position with two men gone. And up next will be the shortstop, Orlando Arcia. The 2-1 home. Now a ball lined towards center field. And that's in there. Base hit. Tack on another here as the runner scores from second. Trevor McGill takes over here with the runner at first and two gone in the inning. Ben Gamel will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Pinch hitting for the Brewers. Number 16, Ben Gamble.
Six runs, nine hits. One error thus far in the game for Milwaukee. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Here's the center fielder. He makes the catch. What a play on the run to end the inning. Alex Claudio will come on out of the bullpen as he'll be appearing in his third game this season.
Number 58, Alex.
Digging in and looking for more, Ian Happ. He's 1-for-2 in this one.
And that last at bat when he went deep, he turned around a pretty good fastball. So I'm kind of thinking this guy's a good fastball hitter. So I might want to move that ball up and down and in and out and try not to throw it right down the middle of the plate.
Pitches away, but it's swung on and grounded to second. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. And is the second baseman, Jason Kipnis. In previous meetings with Alex Claudio, he's just 1-for-6. Right side and right into the shift. And he'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. Nico Horner will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 2, Nico Horner.
Bases are empty here with two men out. And did he go around? No, he did not. Ball two. Here's the Here's a ball swung on and lofted in the air out toward right center. Kane will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Rowan Wick will come on in relief as he'll make his second appearance of the season so far.
Number 50.
Now back to the top of the Milwaukee order, digging in Lorenzo Cain. He struggled at the top of the lineup in this one, hitless to this point. Skied into very shallow right. Hayward has a read on it. One away. Now at the plate, Brock Holt trying to keep it going. A perfect 3-for-3 thus far. Three-two pitch. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So striding forward now, Christian Yelich. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
Now the payoff pitch home. Line toward right center. In there, a base hit. Yelich blows through the stop sign, headed for home, and he's safe at the plate, and they lead now by four.
The first baseman, number five, Jed Jerko.
To the plate now, Jed Jerko. Hit out towards second, and this gets right through him, and that may be a run. And that'll push the lead to five now as it becomes an 8-3 game.
Now batting, the second baseman, Eric.
Stepping in now, Eric Sogard. Fastball well outside.
Somebody's getting frustrated. He's not used to getting hit around like this.
Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there. Pretty much unable to hit any of his spots. And now he's at 3-1, and he's put him into another great hitting count.
And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. And that brings up Javi Baez. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
So it was a strikeout swinging. Javier Baez goes down for the first out in the seventh inning. Here now the 2-2. High and deep down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. Here's another 2-2. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. And right into the shift. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Now the pitch.
Hey, this has been an epic at-bat right here. I don't blame the pitcher for a little nibbling right there. Maybe get a swing and a miss. He didn't bite on that one, so now we go full count.
Chopped up the line to first, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Settling in now, Chris Bryant. Singled home a run in his last time up. Two out, nobody on. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. And this will kick off the base of the wall.
The catcher, number 40, Jason Contreras.
At the plate now, Wilson Contreras. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. And the runner scores from second as they cut away into that deficit here. It's now an 8-4 ball game.
The first baseman, Anthony Rizzo.
In now, Anthony Rizzo. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Lifted down the line and left. Garcia on the run. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning.
For the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Alec Mills gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Striding in once again, Manny Pena. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. The 1-1. And he fouls this one off. The 1-2. Popped him up. Rizzo in foul ground. And no one will track it down. The next 1-2 pitch.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away, so now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
And that's taken high for a ball. It's full now, 3-2.
And just when you needed a shutdown inning, a leadoff walk was certainly not on the agenda. He needs a bear down right here.
Hayward has a read on it, one down. Stepping into the box, Orlando Arcia. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. Bases are empty, one man out. Lazy fly ball out to center field. Hap comes on now and makes the catch in shallow center for round number two. Keston Hiura will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. And that ends the inning. Corey Knebel has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Ready for another chance, Kyle Schwarber, who was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. And it's 1-2.
We're going to see him throw that hard fastball early and often.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Taken off the outside as the breaking ball couldn't catch the corner. Ian Happ will be next. And a good take there will net him a base runner as it's ball four now to start the eighth inning. Stepping in, Ian Happ. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Popped him up. Sogard moving to his left. One away. Stepping in, Jason Kipnis, who could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. And it's two balls and two strikes now. He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. Kane going back. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. Victor Caratini. We'll grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number seven, Victor Caratini.
Still only one out in the inning. And there's ball two now. And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good. So a runner at first now with one away, and with it comes Javi Baez to the plate. The 1-1. Hit the other way out toward right field. After it is Yelich. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that'll bring up the multi-gold glover Jason Hayward. Now the 2-1 pitch.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
The 3-1 is swung on and missed. A full count now.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
High in the air down the right field line. And foul. Once again, a 3-2. Liner toward right center. And this is going to find the alley as he might have himself his second double of the ballgame. And the runner scores all the way from first as they try and chip away at their deficit. It's now an 8-7 ball game. David Phelps enters the ball game out of the pen, looking for the final out here in the top of inning number 8. Into the box now, Chris Bryant. Oh, good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2. This is foul right side. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. Three runs already home here. Ball two.
This is exactly the reason why this guy has been so successful and has played this game so long, scrambling pitch after pitch, making this guy work out on the mound.
Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. He's set. The 2-2.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
Popped up. Jerko is there to make the catch, and they'll get out of this with the lead intact. Ryan Tepera is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the 8th.
Number 52.
Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in Lorenzo Cain. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. This one's blooped out toward right center field. Hayward coming on. He's not going to get to it, so the leadoff guy's aboard with a base hit.
Now batting, third baseman.
Into the box, Brock Holt. And he can't get the bunt down here, so it goes to 2-2.
That's not great form right there, but you can't be surprised. A lot of these guys were not asked to bunt coming up through the minor leagues, so don't expect every sack bunt to get down.
A runner at first with no outs here. Yanked on the ground down the line. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full 3-2.
after multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little disappointing as a pitcher. So you think, say, I'm going to throw one way off the plate and see if he'll chase it. Didn't happen.
Hap comes on now, and he has it one down. In is Christian Yelich. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point.
Christian Yelich.
Lifted in the air to center field. Center fielder giving chase. Lays out, and he's got it. A great play for route number two. So two gone now in the Brewers' half of the eighth, and that'll bring up Abisail Garcia. The 2-1. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. And this one is gone. A home run. At the plate, Jed Jerko.
At the ball.
Inside and low, 2-1. Grounded to short. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Josh Hader comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Number 71.
All set to start the ninth in this one. Now the Cubs four-hole hitter, Wilson Contreras. It was an RBI single for him in his last plate appearance.
They look like they're up against it here, down three on the road, trying to come back against a closer.
Swing and a line drive. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Ready now, Anthony Rizzo. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Rizzo.
The 1-1.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
No offer at that one, and the count moves to 2-2 now on the Cub first baseman. Fouled away.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Kyle Schwarber. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner. Cubs are down to their final strike here, and this is in the air to right, and this should do it. He brings it in, and the Brewers are in the win column for the first time this year as the ball game is over.
Well, there's another save, but that's just not any other save. That's save number 50 for the reliever in his career, well on his way to a nice career.
And this one concludes at a 10-7 score. Milwaukee put a 10 spot on the scoreboard in this one. Brent Suter claims the win out of the pen, his first. John Lester struggled and gets the loss after giving up six earned. Josh Hader earns the save out of the bullpen, his first of the year. So that's a wrap for us here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney on the field, this is Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB Network. Have a good night, everybody.
The final run score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious Brewers, 10 runs, 13 hits, one error, they left seven men on base. For the Cubs, 7 runs on 10 hits, no errors, they left 10 men on base. Time of the ball game, 4 hours and 16 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.